The highly anticipated Matters Chorus Singing Competition presented by Vision Group was launched yesterday at Serena Hotel in Kampala. The guest of honor to this launch was Justice Catherine Mbamgamerere, who expressed the uniqueness in this completion, which she said is skewed towards immortalizing martyrdom through music and is a great idea.
When I thought about the idea that there could be a competition between the choirs in the Anglican faith and the choirs in the Catholic faith to express, to celebrate, to commemorate, and probably to reenact the whole idea of martyrdom as it happened, I was very touched.
Project manager, the Matters Chorus Singing Competition, Max Adi, elaborated on the dynamics that will be involved in conducting this competition as he officially opened for receiving entries of choirs into this competition.
So along the way, we'll be having judges get these videos, and they'll be judging the videos accordingly. So out of all the videos that they will be receiving, they'll get 14 good choirs that will have gone through, and the judging process will be live on all our TV stations, so that there will be transparency.
The competition was launched yesterday, May 2nd, and will culminate in a grand finale event on May 26th, 2024 at the esteemed Kampala Serena Hotel. In recognition of their outstanding performances, the winning Catholic and Anglican choirs will each receive a generous prize of 10 million shillings. Additionally, the first runners-up, each side, will be awarded 5 million shillings, while the second runners-up will receive 3 million shillings. As journalists join the rest of the world to commemorate Press Day today, Mbale Journalists Association, the umbrella that unites media practitioners in Mbale City and Great Bukedi, expressed anger over the incumbent leadership led by Musila Moses, who they contend has refused to hand over office following expiry of his tenure. A section of these regional journalists have chosen to disassociate themselves from the celebrations to commemorate the World Press Day, which is organized by the incumbent leadership.
Ngafe banamawulire abali mu bitundu bino by'embaali twasazeewo olunaku lwaleero tetugenda gwetabamu. It's because their leadership is not straight. Their issues are self-motivated. They are not there for journalists like us.
However, Musila Moses, who is accused of selfish interests and clinging to the leadership, disputes the allegations, saying he's in office legally and has the mandate to organize the World Press Day commemoration event at cricket grounds in Mbale City.
No, I am in office very legally. There are the issues that they have a complex, so I cannot start talking about them now. They actually opted and they made another organization, which I told them, you know what, with organizing a World Press Day, there does not have a limitation that you should, and not, there is no guarantee that you should join us in celebrating it. You can see, we can still organize it through your organization if you want it, and we celebrate.
Today, 3rd May 2024, Uganda, like in the past years, joins the rest of the global community to commemorate the World Press Freedom Day 2024. The day was proclaimed in 1993 by the United Nations General Assembly. Schools and many offices were closed across the United Arab Emirates on Thursday as heavy rains returned to the desert country just 2 weeks after record downpours that experts linked to climate change. A lightning storm with high winds swept across the oil-rich Monarch overnight, with more than 50 millimeters of rain falling before 8 a.m. in some areas, the National Center of Meteorology said. Flooding was seen in some parts of financial hub Dubai and the city's airport, the world's busiest by international passenger traffic, cancelled 13 flights and diverted 5, a spokesperson said. On Thursday, little traffic was seen on Dubai's normally heaving six-lane highways, and cars were abandoned on flooded roads near the sprawling Ibn Battuta Mall. Trucks pumping water were stationed in several flooded areas as Dubai's drainage is often unable to cope with large-scale rainfall. Last month's downpour, which also killed 21 people in neighboring Oman, was the heaviest in the UAE, a majority expatriate federation of seven sheikhdoms since records began in 1949. World Weather Attribution, a network of scientists that assesses the role of climate change in extreme weather events, found the deluge was most likely escalated by global warming caused by burning fossil fuels.